briefly in 1966, when the Vietnam War was heating up, I was not that good of a student, and I knew that I was going to be drafted. And I really didn't want to become cannon fodder. However, I was very fortunate, and cutting straight to it, I applied for a job as an engineer, and I'm not a math guy. I applied for a job as an engineer working for the Ampex Corporation out of Redwood City, California. And ironically enough, out of hundreds of candidates, because that job was something of an unusual job, it would get you a deferment because you would be serving your country without having to go over and have your head blown off. I was accepted. And for the first 6 months of my job, I didn't have a job. I went through batteries of psychological tests 3 times a week by as many as 5 different doctors. Some were psychiatrists, some were psychologists, and I'm sure that the names that I had, not one of them was real. I began to see the pattern in the questions that they were asking. And then one of them confided in me. He said, you know, of course, since 1952, Mark, the United States government, though computers were very primitive, if even existing at that time, they nevertheless kept track of all of the children enrolled in public schools that had either special needs or they had special talents. And my special talent was I couldn't talk. And it was not from lack of vocal cords. It was the fact that I stuttered so horribly that I just gave up. This was something that the government became very interested in because I lived in my head until I was about 16.